Hi, I am Sheikh Mahbub Basha. Welcome to my channel. Happy learning.
Hi students, welcome. Today we will solve few numerical problems. Before that, let us recollect the two formulas we have learned. Number one is Q equal to ms delta t. Where Q is the heat energy, m is the mass of the substance, s is the specific heat of the substance, delta T is the change in temperature. This formula has to be used when there is no phase change, only rise or fall of temperature is there. Number 2, Q equal to ML. Q equal to ML, where Q is the heat energy, M is mass of the substance, L is latent heat. If it is fusion, you have to use the latent heat of fusion. If it is vaporization, you have to use the latent heat of vaporization. So remember, this Q is equal to ML formula is used during phase change. Solid to liquid, liquid to gas, or reverse, gas to liquid, liquid to solid, like that. Whenever there is a phase change, you have to use the formula Q equal to ML, and whenever there is a rise in temperature without any phase change, then you have to use the formula Q equal to ms delta T. These two formulas are very popular, and in most of the competitive exams also you get for problems based on these formulas. So practice these questions.
Problem number 1. How much energy is transferred when 1 gram of boiling water at 100 degrees Celsius is condensed to water at 100 degrees Celsius? Before we solve this problem, let us read this problem once again. How much energy is transferred when 1 gram of boiling water at 100 degrees Celsius condenses to water at 100 degrees Celsius? Here we should note down that the temperature is constant, only phase change is taking place. Steam is condensed to water, so gaseous phase is changed to liquid phase. Therefore, this is the case of phase change only, but not the change of temperature. Now let us write down the given data. Mass of water, let it be m, is equal to, it is given as 1 gram. Energy transferred, let us give the symbol Q, capital Q, and it is equal to question mark. It is what we need to find out. Then, as the steam is condensed to water, we need latent heat of vaporization. Its symbol is capital L and its value is 540 calorie per gram. Here temperature is constant, only phase change is taken place, and hence formula we need to use is Q equal to ML. Substituting the values 1 in place of M, 540 in place of L, and simplification, the value is 540 calories. Therefore, when 1 gram of boiling water at 100 degrees Celsius is condensed to water at 100 degrees Celsius, the energy liberated is 540 calories. So the answer is 540 calories. Problem number 2. How much energy is released or absorbed when 1 gram of water at 0 degrees Celsius freezes to ice at 0 degrees Celsius? Let us read this problem carefully. How much energy is released or absorbed when 1 gram of water at 0 degree Celsius freezes to ice at 0 degree Celsius? Observe carefully. Here the temperature is constant. Initially, temperature of water is 0 degree Celsius and finally temperature of ice is 0 degree Celsius. Here there is no change of temperature, but there is a change in phase. Water is freezed to ice, so change of phase is taking place from water to ice. Let us write down the given data. Mass of water M is equal to 1 gram. Energy released Q equal to question mark. As the water is freezed to ice, here energy will be released. So let it be equal to Q and it is equal to question mark. This value we need to find out. As this is the fusion of water to ice, latent heat of fusion L equal to 80 calorie per gram. Here temperature is constant, only phase change is taken place. Therefore, the formula should be Q equal to ML. Substituting the values, M is 1 and L is 80. On simplification, we get the final value as 80. And because it is heat energy, its unit is calories. Q equal to 80 calorie is the answer. Therefore, when 1 gram of water at 0 degree Celsius freezes to ice at 0 degree Celsius, then the energy liberated is 80 calories. Problem number 3. How much energy is required to convert 1 gram of ice at 0 degree Celsius to steam at 100 degree Celsius? Let us read this problem once again thoroughly and carefully. How much energy is required to convert 1 gram of ice at 0 degree Celsius to steam at 100 degree Celsius? Okay, so initially it is ice and its temperature is 0 degree Celsius. At last, finally, it is steam and it is at 100 degree Celsius. So ice has become steam. Ice has become steam and temperature has changed from 0 degree Celsius to 100 degree Celsius. That means here there is a rise of temperature and also change of phase. Ice to steam. And we know ice cannot be directly converted into steam. The ice has to change into water. Again, water will change to steam. So in this problem, there is rise of temperature, there is change of phase from ice to water, and also there is change of phase from water to steam. So we have to solve this problem very carefully. Let us write down the given data. Mass of ice M equal to 1 gram. Initial temperature of ice T1 equal to 0 degree Celsius. Final temperature of steam T2 is equal to 100 degree Celsius. Heat energy required, let it be capital Q, that is equal to question mark. We are asked to find this value for Q. Let us solve this problem in three stages. First, let us start with the ice at 0 degree Celsius. Then it is converted to water at 0 degree Celsius. Hence, the first stage is conversion of ice at 0 degree Celsius to water at 0 degree Celsius. Next, let the water at 0 degree Celsius is converted to water at 100 degree Celsius. Therefore, the second stage is conversion of water at 0 degrees Celsius to water at 100 degrees Celsius. And the third stage is water is converted to steam. So the third stage is conversion of water at 100 degrees Celsius to steam at 100 degrees Celsius. So we have divided the actual problem into three stages. Number one is conversion of ice at 0 degrees Celsius to water at 0 degrees Celsius. And second stage is conversion of water at 0 degrees Celsius to water at 100 degrees Celsius. And third stage is conversion of water at 100 degrees Celsius to steam at 100 degrees Celsius. Let us take the stage 1, which is conversion of ice at 0 degrees Celsius to water at 0 degrees Celsius. Let us write the data. Mass of ice M is equal to 1 gram. Energy required Q1 is equal to question mark. Latent heat of fusion L is equal to 80 calorie per gram. As it is a case of phase change ice to water at constant temperature, the formula should be Q equal to ML. Substituting the values, Q1 is equal to 1 into 80. So on simplification, Q1 equal to 80 calories. Therefore, when 1 gram of ice at 0 degrees Celsius converted to water at 0 degrees Celsius, then the energy required is 80 calories. Now, let us take the second stage. Conversion of water at 0 degrees Celsius to water at 100 degrees Celsius. Mass of ice M is equal to 1 gram. Initial temperature of water T1 equal to 0 degrees Celsius. Final temperature of water T2 equal to 100 degrees Celsius. Energy required Q2 is equal to question mark. Specific heat of water S is equal to 1 calorie per gram. As it is the case of change in temperature, we need to use the formula Q is equal to Ms delta T. Here, the heat energy we have named as Q2. Therefore, Q2 is equal to Ms in place of delta T, T2 minus T1. Final temperature minus initial temperature. That is equal to 1 into 100 minus 0. On simplification, Q2 is equal to 100 calories. Therefore, when 1 gram of water at 0 degrees Celsius is converted to water at 100 degrees Celsius, then the energy required is 100 calories. Now, let us move to the stage 3, that is conversion of water at 100 degrees Celsius to steam at 100 degrees Celsius. Mass of water M is equal to 1 gram. Energy required Q3 is equal to question mark. Latent heat of vaporization L is equal to 540 calorie per gram. As it is the case of phase change, we need to use the formula Q is equal to ML. So Q3 is equal to 1 into 540. Substituted 1 in place of M, 540 in place of L, that is equal to 540 calories. Therefore, when 1 gram of water at 100 degrees Celsius is converted to steam at 100 degrees Celsius, then the energy required is 540 calories. Now, let us rewrite the three stages. In the stage 1, when 1 gram of ice at 0 degrees Celsius converted to water at 0 degrees Celsius, then the energy required is Q1 is equal to 80 calories. And in the second stage, when 1 gram of water at 0 degrees Celsius is converted to water at 100 degrees Celsius, then the energy required is Q2 is equal to 100 calories. And in the third stage, when 1 gram of water at 100 degrees Celsius is converted to steam at 100 degrees Celsius, Then the energy required is Q3 is equal to 540 calories. So Q1 equal to 80 calorie, Q2 equal to 100 calorie, Q3 equal to 540 calories. Then if you include all the three stages and express in one single stage, then we can write when 1 gram of ice at 0 degrees Celsius converted to steam at 100 degrees Celsius, then the energy required is Q is equal to Q1 plus Q2 plus Q3. Substitute the values. In the stage 1, we have calculated the Q1 as 80 calories. In the stage 2, we have calculated the Q2 as 100 calories. In the stage 3, we have calculated the Q3 as 540 calories. So on simplification, Q is equal to 720 calories. So this is the final answer we need. Therefore, total energy required to convert 1 gram of ice at 0 degrees Celsius into steam at 100 degrees Celsius is 720 calories.